All right, so first off, Silly and Piamet, since you're both here right now, I'm going to invite you. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Well, I am a blacksmith,
Okay,
so I
well.
can hammer time.
All right, so stop being a blacksmith.
Whatever you want me to be.
Or Juba, would you like to tank? Or DPS?
They would like to DPS.
Oh.
Yeah, because my Dark Knight is 35.
Okay.
So I'll play. Play White Mage Astrologian. I don't know if I get cards yet as Astrologian.
Don't remember.
I'll play White Mage.
Oh, okay. Juba wants the DPS.
I think White Mage is probably stronger at lower levels.
All right, so we've seen Juba before, and he's going to come along with us. Excellent. All right, so is everybody the role that they want to be? Let's make sure Juba is the role he wants to be.
And Mira will get all the gear.
Is Juba able to be in the call?
I don't know. You'll have to invite him if he is.
Okay.
Here we go. Okay, so Brayflox longstop. After a tiring journey across the Osier, it is deep within the quiet jungles of Raincatcher Gully where the charismatic and enterprising young goblin, Brayflox Altox, chooses to build her tiny empire. What she does not realize, however, is that something else, something sinister, has also made the lush forest its home. Now, driven from her rightful claim, Brayflox and her brethren seek to retake the land and are not above asking the help of lesser races, that would be you, to help them do so. All right.
I
Juba
echo
says he
him,
wants
I
in.
think.
Oh, yeah, there he is. Hello, Juba.
Hello.
Okay, so
Hi.
Juba, unfortunately, since you are also bard, you're gonna try and steal my gear. You can't do that.
I switched to machinist.
Okay, so since you're machinist, you can't steal my gear.
My machinist is level 46.
Okay. Brayflox
Machinist
longstop.
is also level 46.
I was entirely kidding.
This is gear, Juba. God.
I was entirely kidding, though. I don't care if you roll on shit.
All right, and turn on your cutscenes too.
Oh, yes.
Yep.
Okay,
I know.
so here's the opening cutscene. Well, that was a mighty big looking beast. You can still kind of see his tail in the distance. What could that be? Alright, so this is Brayflox Longstop. In my opinion, when I first played this game, this dungeon was the first really, I don't want to say challenging, but it was the first dungeon that posed a challenge. But it is a very pretty outdoor dungeon. Like it said in the description, it is in a rainforest. We got Juba there making really loud lalafell noises. It might be the colibri too, though. Cawing at Silly and the rest of the group. Alright, there we go. As you can see, the monsters here consist of colibris and monkeys. Well, yeah, monkeys. That's an adequate description of it. Closer to lemurs, but. Rock breaker! Not entirely sure why the machinists and bards have to make, well, maybe bards I can understand because you gotta pull the bow, drawstring on the bow, but machinists, why you have to like make sounds when you attack, because you're not giving any physical exertion at all.
Because anime.
I've been like talking and I've been muted.
I'm very proud of you. Okay, so we're gonna go up here and talk to this goblin pathfinder. Okay, give me a moment here.
heavy folk in danger. Uplanders, take gate key. Open head gate.
Alright. So we got the key. We're going to head back this way, and we are going to cross back across the river over this log into more painted colibris and a raveled rain catcher, which is an Ochu. There we go. So there's the run stop headgate that we gotta get through. Behind the gate, you can kinda see the other boss when I turn back to it. Or the first boss. That great yellow pelican is the first boss of this dungeon. And he's a toughie. Not really. Kind of a joke. But I have actually seen people wipe on it. Somehow. It happens. I'm not gonna use Fist of Earth. Why would I use Fist of Earth?
You might get poisoned.
I don't care about that.
I do. If you get... You got poisoned.
Yeah. See, then I'll put Fist of Earth on, but now it's gone, so...
Yeah, because I dispelled it.
Yeah, which is what you're supposed to do. Internal release up. Lots of critical hits now. Look at that 10 damage with touch of death. Bloodshine, if I'm behind the enemy, will always give a critical hit as long as I am in Obo-Obo stance. Or the enemy doesn't have awareness on. Okay, there we go. Demolish is going back up. Second internal release. And Monk. The downside to this dungeon is I cannot use Shoulder Tackle here.
I can't use Blood Price.
Yeah. I noticed that you're having some MP issues. Are you using your MP combo?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not having MP issues. Like, I know what I'm... Like, on that one pull, I just unleashed too many times when I didn't need to. And
oh.
But...
Because, like, I was tanking this the other day for, like, with Sylvie healing me. And, I just pretty much stuck to my MP combo, like, all the time. I had no threat problems. Granted, the DPS were pugs, but... That's pretty much what I do now that they've buffed the tank stance. It used to be a lot harder to manage your MP because, like, you'd have to use the threat combo a lot more than you do now.
But hey, a sugar loaf hat. Oh. I don't want that, though.
You don't want to be a dunce?
No. Why would I want that?
You know it double dips off blood weapon, right?
Yeah. What double? What do you mean double dips?
You get twice the MP if you use your MP combo while you have blood weapon on. So yeah, MP combo, lots.
Oops. Okay, that's weird. I got threat on the Drake.
That's because you hit it too much.
Well, the Drake is what you're supposed to kill first. It's a Drake.
What did you say?
Dragonflies.
Do you want to explore the back areas of this?
No. It's up to you. You're the...
Well, PMS said no, so I'm going to say yes.
What if I said yes?
Then I would have said yes.
So, where are we? We're going up the...
Going this way.
Oh, I totally forgot that this even existed.
What the fuck? This is where you go into hard mode.
Yeah. Rock breaker! There we go. We gotta save the goblins. I mean, that's what we're here to do.
I never save any of them.
I know you're
the one that gives you the key.
Oh, you saved the one at the start too, and the one that being attacked by the goblin the comet chasers at the beginning. Hello, congrats, Silly.
Only the ones that I have to.
I just got
hand lending.
One picked up the treasure coffer after that.
That's okay. I can't even use that. That's rude.
By the way, Silly, I don't know if you're like low on MP, but Dark Side out of combat, you regen more than it saps.
Yeah, but also if it's a shorter period of time and you want to regen it quick, you can turn it off because it regens faster if it's off than if it's on.
Yes, but it also costs MP to reapply it.
You're an MP.
Yes?
Listen, PMA, you're giving me a lot of unsolicited advice. Just kidding.
I just hate bad Dark Knights. And you're not a bad Dark Knight.
Thanks for adding that at the end.
But I don't want you to be a bad Dark Knight. I want to teach you the ways of PMA.
I've never been bad at any class.
Hey, another Sugarloaf hat. In case you didn't get the first one, there you go. Hang on, I'm gonna climb up this tower.
Yeah. Oh, right, this tower.
There's nothing up here except for this dude. Hand lending!
Where did hand lending?
I wanted you a finger.
Alright. Now we're gonna cross the bridge here, and we're gonna go up this ramp and help this goblin up at the top.
He's pretty much dead, probably. Oh, wait, no, they haven't attacked him yet.
No, they give you a few moments to get up there.
Yeah, dude, look at him. He's fine. I don't like not having regen. I feel like I should have it at this level.
I think you get it at 35.
God damn it.
I don't like having my...
Yeah.
The last dungeon I did for Daily Roulette on my Light Mage was Karn, and I was like, this feels so wrong to not have Shroud.
Oh. Like,
so annoying.
Alright, victory. Excellent.
And Chazier. I really need Shroud till...
Ethereal Toadskin Breaches. I can't even cook those. What is this? Alright, so here's the second boss, the Inferno Drake.
Your Lancer could equip them, actually.
Oh, that's true. I should have greeted.
Shot on it. I can sleep it.
Okay.
You're gonna sleep the furniture?
Just keep an eye on when the Tempest thing comes out. And if, Piamat, you're gonna have to voice something during this, so speak up when you do.
Oh, god damn it. I'm healing.
Yeah. There it is.
Albeit.
Oh, I gotta wait till it stops moving. And it was just mirrored. So, stand close to Brayflox so you can see when she...
She's gonna attack me. I don't understand her. Gobby boom. Go, go. Fire boom, over boom. She's chasing me, so put on grit. I like never used blood weapon once I got grit. It's weird.
It's actually, I feel like there's less of a reason to use grit when it's chasing you, because it's not like I can make him stop chasing.
Didn't know that the Drake would also chase me.
Yeah, Brayflox taunts it.
Basically, what Brayflox is doing is like, I don't want to get hit by this, so I'm just going to have it chase me around and like, here, I'm going to bring it to you. They just pick a random person.
Yeah.
Brayflox was talking.
Well, you should be using grit, though.
Well, when it's not attacking me, what's the point?
Basically, Brayflox is being a better party member than about 90% of ranged DPS.
Be 100% uptime on grit and dark side. That's my philosophy.
Sounds good.
It is good. I do it. Like, yeah, mistakes happen sometimes and you run out of MP, but get it back. So it's like 99%. You include dark side on it.
Alright. So that's the second of four bosses down.
I literally didn't commend a Dark Knight tank last night because he wasn't managing his stances and MP, right?
Man. What about if you play a Bard and you just spam Iron Jaws with only one bite? Is that okay?
Yeah!
Look how pretty the long stop is. Even at night, it's got like these glowing lilies. Look at that, though. Like the waterfalls down the side. I'm going in this sideway first.
I saw an Instagram of like a really pretty house that someone got.
Hey, Sully, come over here.
Oh, right, this way.
They got like an FC mansion.
Yeah.
And they put all these pretty trees in front. It's like, damn. Inspiration. Like, I kind of look at our front yard and I feel like I need a renovation.
Okay. Nobody would fault you if you decided to renovate. It's cool to change things around every now and then.
No.
Yeah.
You know what's cool? To not drop grit.
Do you want to kill those ones in the middle or we can just go by them?
Just go by them. Just showing off the dungeon so much, we don't really need to kill everything.
Yeah, Miro's already over leveled.
I'm gonna be over leveling more when I do my daily for this So, well, kinda. I gotta get Lancer one more level.
Oh, are you doing your leveling roulette on stream?
No, I'm not gonna do that on stream.
Oh, okay.
F that.
That's true.
The stream is for story, and then when I get to the end of the story that's available, I'm gonna start turning it into guild events.
I'm gonna start DPSing more.
Well, FC events.
Prepare your anus, as they say.
Hey, I got a question for you. Are you able to fit an entire Razor Naga up your butthole?
It is true.
I see.
Just because I can doesn't mean I'm not a professional gamer girl.
Okay.
So.
Hey, we just killed the Gully Galaga. See? There it goes.
Nice.
Excellent. And then Juba's there with his little gun.
Pew 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 pew.
Alright.
While being all anime and making all of the sounds.
Another swamp people coming in, silly.
Yeah.
Did it turn around? No, okay, there it is. It's just a lot slower than I anticipated.
It was gonna get Piamat.
Yeah, it was gonna run into her eventually, so.
Well, I moved.
Yeah, but that's what I mean. It's like, that's why Peanut moved, because it was gonna happen.
She's got a craving for Wendy's spicy chicken sandwich.
Go get that's one.
I want a Frosty from Wendy's.
I like her fries. They make some of the best fries.
Have you had Popeye's fries?
Wait, Peanut, do you mean the fries they have now or the fries they used to have?
The fries they have now? I don't know what fries they used to have.
I used to like their fries back in the day. They, like, changed the recipe.
Ew, you're so gross.
What?
I knew you would do that. And say, like, oh, their fries now aren't good. Like,
no, they're not. They are good. But I like the other fries better. That's all I'm saying.
I don't know. Maybe your Wendy's are fucked up and taste bad, but...
I didn't say I dislike the fries now. I just said I like the old fries better.
These fries are like fresh cut potatoes.
Piamat?
Yeah, they're good, but like, I like them.
Piamat, do you remember we watched that video about how wine tasters, wine experts are full of shit?
They are, yeah.
Okay, so I'd like to point out that that applies to this conversation because...
I don't remember that video.
Everybody's taste buds are different, so...
No, my taste buds are the correct taste buds, is what Vienna's trying to say.
Okay, okay. Here's our second boss.
These fries are really good because you can go anywhere for, like, any other kind of fry, but the Wendy's fries, Wendy's is the only place I've had fries like that. It's got, like, the potato skins on them. Like, come on.
The, fries from Popeye's, I think it's Fist of Earth. The fries for Popeye's and this place I used to go called Dandy's Burgers were amazing. I can't stun that, unfortunately. So this boss is primarily just move from the AoE if he gets selected for bug, you can't, nothing you can do about it. But then he also has this thing where he summons a queer bubble over top of the character.
Yeah.
And you gotta kill it.
And the person in the bubble can attack it too, but since they're so debuffed, it does, like, way less.
Most classes, you don't really notice too much of a difference, because, yeah, it just you're doing less damage, but you're still doing damage. I find it to be especially noticeable if you're on Black Mage.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Just because their hits are, like, so significantly greater than the other classes at this point, and they have a cast time.
Silly, why so much grit removal?
I don't need it!
Piamat, stop
if
complaining
you don't need
about.
A threat, then just use your MP combo.
Save your discussions about what Silly should be doing with Black Knight, Dark Knight outside of the stream, please. And as you can see, the dragon here just decided to interject himself into the battle, kill our boss, and then fly off.
He ate it.
The moon is not full.
I just know as Dark Knight, I use MP combo like 90% of the time.
So do I. But
yeah, it's super good. I'm very super famous.
Indeed. Yay, Longstop Gut Gate.
No worries, it's called the Gut Gate.
People got gutted to keep it open.
I want Holy and Regen.
Alright. What about Holy Regen?
I don't give a shit about Holy right now, but I want Regen so that it's like ticking on you while I'm slowly casting stone. Two.
Yeah, you can fit more stone twos in. If you have Regen on someone.
Yeah.
I know the feeling.
As you can see, this part of the long stop, not quite as pretty and a lot more destroyed objects.
So I don't really care too much about DPSing, but currently at this level, Monk and Gunslinger are like not at their...
What are you talking about? We're doing fine amount of DPS.
Yeah, I mean, of course you guys are doing great for the level you are. But, like, there's, like, no AoE. But Miro sometimes has AoE.
Silly, don't forget there's a, Comet Chaser that's gonna come back, yeah.
Oh, well, Jupiter does have that spread shot. Here.
What, you mean the non-existent quick knock?
What? Non-existent?
It's basically quick knock.
Yeah, Rock Breaker is...
non-existent, though?
Does no damage.
What? Well, you wouldn't want to use it on two targets.
I spam it. I spam it on every target.
Yeah, Rock Breaker is, not worth it if you have less than three targets.
Yeah.
That actually reminds me of that video we like the link of how the classes play. And that's actually what the machinist is doing in the video. He's spamming.
Yeah.
He's spamming spread shot on the target dummy with, and he's like, I have no idea what I'm doing, but that's okay because neither is anyone else.
I think it's a girl.
I don't think so, but maybe.
Yeah, it's a girl.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I stand corrected. I could have sworn it was a dude. That's because I am a chauvinistic pig.
Chauvinistical.
I like how she purposefully, like, makes these words that are, like, close to what they could be, but they are not the right word.
I don't know how she does all this shit. Like,
I like how...
I was deliriously tired, and I came to this conclusion that, like, she would be amazing for something like Saturday Night Live, since her, like, fucking improv live is so on point.
Yeah, but I like how she takes words that end in ED and she pronounces the ed part of it.
Ed.
I picketed it.
You guys hacked me. And channel 4. So she goes 4chan.
Look at all this debris laying around, Silly. Like, clean it up.
Ryan.
I can't believe someone in the Malice Network is like, go look it up on 4chan. I'm like, yeah, and...
Look up what on 4chan? Nothing, ever?
Look at this debris. Like, bent wheels, parts of houses, or buildings.
Arrow, clean up your room.
I keep trying to use Arrow, too. I'm
not gonna do that.
But, yeah,
Archer Ring? Fuck this game. It's supposed to be Marauder Ring, or...
I'll take that.
I'll agree on that. Yeah, Mirod.
Miro took it from Juba. Aww.
Miro's gonna level Archer for her stream eventually.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, for the, Well, not really for stream, for YouTube, but yeah. It'll get good use.
Take more than 2 minutes.
Maybe.
Oh man, when you said you were gonna do the monk quest, I thought you meant like turning into a monk, and I was like, why haven't you done that yet?
You're a loser.
Yeah.
Alright, here's the end boss of Brayflox Longstop. It is our good friend the dragon who fucked with us earlier. This boss is primarily why groups would fail back when I first played this game. Okay. Mostly because people didn't know how to move, tanks didn't know how to position, and you'd get a scholar healer.
Aww.
Come on, I played a scholar.
Not to say.
Scholars are good. I had a group where I think it was with Sylvie actually. I think the range stood way too close.
Well.
And that's also a problem.
I'm not saying that scholars are bad. I'm just saying this part of the game was not well thought out of, with scholars in mind.
Well, giving scholars leeches at level 40 wasn't well thought out for. Anything.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, they didn't think that out too well because they added this fight in where poison is quite frequent and can stack up to 4 times and it ends up doing a ton of damage.
Well, there's also the sludge balls and Cutter's Cry.
Yeah, but...
Where you can be 40 at max.
The reason I'm mentioning this fight is because it's a lot more prominent here and obvious.
Yeah.
Because, like, you die in Cutter's Cry, sure, but most people don't remember that, whereas they remember this.
It's on Miro, is it?
Yeah, you're good, though. You don't have to move it.
Good job, Miro. Dude, Miro is fucking awesome. Maybe just don't hate. Okay. So now I need to move, like, forward, like, a lot because of that. Not because of Miro, but because of the boss moving.
It's okay.
I'm way out of range. I need one of those, like, wow add-ons. It's like, I cannot heal you. I cannot heal you. And then the Read Finder add-on, that would be like, this person is not in the correct role.
Oh, that was a good one.
Hey, you didn't pick me for once.
This person is not in a tank stance. This person is not in Fists of the Air.
I don't need to be in Fists of the Air. I can get away with the vomit quicker if I have Fist of the Wind on.
That's true. Fine.
Fuck your granite rain, buddy.
Target is not in range. Why did I keep losing range on you?
He knocks me back.
So, does?
Yeah.
I don't remember him doing that to me.
Granite rain knocks you back. Ah!
Oh, when you stand in it.
You almost pulled him out of range of my limit.
You,
There you go.
Can dodge that.
There's no telegraph for it.
Yeah, no, he just casts it. I dodged it, but just because it was a dodge. There we go, victory! We won! We cleared out the long stop for Brayflox. Juba Dingles attains level 47. Congrats, Juba! Alright, and let's see what we get. Fuck you. New cavalry chest piece. Oh well, I'm gonna be probably getting this for roulette, so. Alright, let's talk to these goblins. He doesn't say anything. Brayflox doesn't say anything, you're rude. Oh, great, Brayflox said gobby boom. Alright.
That's all she says.
She really shit, yeah. Alright, is there a cutscene? I don't think there is at this point. Nope. Okay, gonna share screen again. Alright. You guys see that? Look at that. We went in at nighttime and we came out just after daybreak. Alright, Gobby, Brayflox, let's chat.
Go. Goodly Uplander had thanks of Gobby Flock. Flighty Beast was tricksy foe, but Uplander outwitted with plans making. Uplander is goodly head for fighty think. Brayflox happy gives tasty fresh Gobby treats the clever Uplander. Cheese is stinky sweet Gobby treat. Special make with secret Gobby arts. No party complete without Gobby Gouda, Brayflox every say.
Yeah, we got goblin cheese, Gobby Gouda.
I would not eat that even if I ate cheese.
What if it was the type of cheese that you do eat?
No.
Alright, so we got the egg, we got the meat, we got the cheese. We got everything that this guy's asked for thus far. Hopefully now he will tell us how to fight Titan. Or how to find Titan. He doesn't tell us shit about how to fight him. I gather you solved Brayflox's little problem? Goblin cheese. The pungent odor of this hard yellow cheese veined with blue-green mold is most comparable to the warm, damp boot of a zombie after stepping in ripe chocobo dung. Goblins claim it is a delicacy, but then again, they have their masks filter out the aroma. Ugh, that does sound pretty awful. By the gods, that unholy stench! This, definitely goblin cheese. Judging from the smell, this should be quite flavorful. How's it made? It's best you remain ignorant of such things. I still remember when I learned what kind of milk they use. What do you mean you forgot the wine? Wisecat would like to congratulate you on a job well done. Bravo, Mira. Thanks to you, I guess I'll be honored with a marvelous banquet. But what good is an exotic feast without an equally exalted aperitif? Aye, your work is not yet finished. Before we can discuss Titan, you must first bring us a suitable wine. Speak with Dryswit over yonder. He is overseeing preparations for the banquet, and we'll tell you what we must do. Juba, are you ready?
Yep.
You get to voice your first character today, so make sure you speak up because you're a little quiet today.
Beg your pardon, madam, but I've got my hands full with... Oh, you're the adventurer sent to pick up the wine. Thank the gods, we've nothing on hand that will meet with Master Gedgeru's approval. Take this order slip and run along to Wineport. One of Weisket's friends from the old days, Samani Lamani, is our supplier. Who'd have thought that a former mercenary would have such refined taste, eh? Everyone here agrees he's a natural vintner. If you're lucky, maybe he'll let you have a taste.
Alright, so now we're going to stay in this zone, but we're going to go up to Wineport, which I didn't go to before because it wasn't on the way to the Longstop. It was kind of like off path from it. So now we are heading north through the Bloodshore. You get a good idea, better view of everything now because it's daytime. But look at that view over there. So pretty. There's even a boat. There's some goblins there. I think this is the first time we've seen... Oh, not goblins. Kobolds. I think it's the first time we've seen kobolds. Maybe? Maybe not. Either way. Okay, cool, silly. That's fine.
Have fun.
Thank you for voicing and doing stuff.
No problem.
Alright, so here we are back in Rainkeller... Raincatcher Gully. And we're going to head up here towards this big orange crystal. But again, we're not going to be focusing on this yet. We'll do that later. Lock Swift Saber. Hello. Oh, I got the Dread Chocobo. We will explore that later. Now, we're going to stop in here. Remember to do the... to grab the Aetherite. And a lot of people used to hang out here back in the day because this is where the entrance to the first raid they ever released was. Choco Keep. And you couldn't queue in via Duty Finder. You had to actually go to the entrance. Well, they put an entrance nearby here, so you didn't have to run all the way to the entrance, but you get the idea. Alright, so, Piamet. No, wait. This is the boy. Hellvison. Sweet grime and blood. Ah, you reek of blood! An adventurer, unless I'm mistaken. What brings you to Wineport? Aperitif order slip. An order made out to Wineport vintner Shamani Lamani. Oops. Okay. There. An order? Let me guess. A request for the finest vintage I can muster? The paper smells of Loman perfume. Costa de Sol, and there's also... unmistakable odor of goblin cheese! Yes, Master Gegaruju would not settle for anything less than the best. Durstwitz and his crew must be quite busy preparing an exotic feast, hence his decision to rely on an adventurer. Ah, but perhaps you are confused. This display of deduction was not intended to impress you. When one loses his vision, he is forced to compensate in other ways. But you have no interest in my affairs. You wish only to discuss the wine, I suspect. Okay, I get a choice between poisoning potion, blinding potion, and silencing potion. Hey, Pima, you know what else is a poisoning potion?
What?
I linked it for you. An offer you can refuse. Shamani Lamani would like to discuss wine with you. Life can be so delightfully unpredictable. I always had a passion for wine, but it wasn't until I was forced to retire that I could pursue it as more than a mere hobby. It wouldn't have been possible if not for savings I amassed during my time as a mercenary, of course. Say what you will about the nature of that work. None can deny it pays well. Ah, but you grow impatient. And Dirtswitz must have his wine. Herein lies the problem. Nothing in my possession is sufficient quality for his occasion. The best vintages in town are hoarded by Berglant, who owns and operates the largest winery in Vilbrand. Somehow, I doubt he'll be receptive to your request, but given these circumstances, we must needs beg his assistance. What's a guy at you? I don't know. I don't remember mentioning a guy at you. Berglant. Alright, you can voice Berglant, Juba.
What rank amateur bottled this wine? The impurities have rendered it nigh undrinkable. Oisamal is too good for the man responsible. You should be made to drink every drop of this polluted swill. What is it? I'm in the middle of an important discussion, and I do not care for interruptions. Hmm? That neophyte vintner bid you to speak with me? Ha! Neither you nor your friend has the palate to appreciate the subtle qualities of my private stock. I would sooner serve you goobu urine than sell you my worst vintage. Be gone from my sight.
How rude. Look at these barrels. Shamani Lamani. I take it he said no. Really, in those words? Well, I can't say I'm surprised. Well, there's no denying his passion and skill. The wine baron of Linsa Laminsa is not a man known for his tact. Very well, we shall have to take an alternative approach. It won't work. Shamani Lamani has another bright idea. There is a chance, however, that yet another resident of Wineport can furnish us the suitable wine. In fact, had you come several years ago, I guarantee this would not be a problem. Alas, the quality of our product has declined significantly in recent years. The only breeds cultivating these days are common lowland vines, which isn't to say that their grapes are of poor quality, only that we have known better. Long ago, the Vignerons of Wenport crossbred several species and produced a grape-bearing vine of a never-before-seen quality. Bacchus grapes were once the pride of this town, and they were used to produce vintages which surpassed all others. This includes the most aromatic, and most complex, the most flavorful of all wines! Aye, the legendary Bacchus wines were born right here in Wineport. Pardon my enthusiasm, you see, I once had the privilege to sample that particular wine. It was an otherworldly experience. In that moment, I felt as though I had tasted the nectar of the gods themselves. I transcended my mortal flesh and was one with all creation. But as is all too often said, the calamity changed that. The Bacchus vineyards were completely destroyed, along with much of the existing stock of Bacchus wine. What little remains is closely guarded by its owners, for it can no longer be made. If we cannot convince Burgland to part with his wine, our next option, as ridiculous as it sounds, is to find someone who has a bottle of Bacchus wine and to offer them every gill we can spare. I've heard rumors that one of the Vignerons tending the vineyards might have once owned a bottle. Perhaps you could start by speaking with them. Are you up behind the house? I think this person's behind the house. They're there. It is Fulbrum. You a lady? You look like a lady. Wait a minute.
Okay. I think your stream is frozen.
Okay, let me reset it.
Your stream. Durham?
Yeah, give me a sec. Okay.
Sorry, it's loading. No, sorry. Bacchus wine? Bah, don't remind me. You used to have a cellar filled with the stuff. Thought I could keep the wine safe from thieves and the elements. Never counted on a bloody primal blowing up my goddamned house.
Well, yeah, I suppose that's not something people would account for very often. Should zoom out. Nobody wants to look at Miro's back that closely.
Where's your dodo?
That's a good question. Where is my dodo? Right there. Jungbar! What? Do I have Bacchus wine? I wish! I never had the chance to try it myself. Sorry, friend, but you're a few years too late. Well. The Vignerons are not like to help me, then. Let's go back and talk to the little Lalafell over here. No luck, hmm? Most regrettable, but we had to try. Ah, but Bacchus wine would have been perfect for the occasion. Though I must confess, my certitude would be due in part to my personal history with the beverage. It is, after all, the very reason I decided to become a vendor. After Titan blinded me in our battle beneath Ilgomoro, I fell into a deep depression. It wasn't until I tasted Bacchus wine for the first time that I realized that there is still much I could experience, even in my condition. It helped me to find a new direction in life. It breaks my heart to think that this wonderful ambrosia, which once filled me with hope, may be forever lost to us. There we go, high potion of strength. Yay, level 36. And I learned enhanced internal release. So, we'll throw our point into strength, accept. Okay, so what enhanced internal release does is improves the critical rate granted by increase granted by internal release to 30% from 10%, I think. Shimani Lamani. Give a man a drink. Shimani Lamani appears to be deep in thought. I must say, this talk of Bacchus wine has made me rather nostalgic. Indeed, there is much I miss about my life with the company of heroes. After everything the captain has done for me, I could not bear to disappoint him. I have no fear. I swear that I shall find a suitable wine for the banquet, though I may need some time to think of a solution. In the meantime, there is a favor I would ask of you. 2 years ago, in the deepest depths of my despair, I stumbled across Vilbrand as a vagabond drunk. I suspect I was looking for a place to die, because I nearly fairly found one not far from here. It was there that a man named Jess took me and nursed me back to health. And it was he who gave me my first taste of Bacchus wine, which helped me to find my new calling. Though I am still a novice in the arts of winemaking, I would like him to know that I am pursuing my dream. This wine is my own original creation, and I would be most grateful if you would deliver it to him in my stead. Jess sometimes works in the Raincatcher Gully Duck, so perhaps Ritz's Guild can tell you where to find him. Alright, Juba, you get to voice Dressed. Is that cool with you?
Yep.
Okay. Gotta love that Chocobo theme song. And look how pretty this place looks, just like, during the day. It's awesome. Ritzskilt is right here. Where's Ritzskilt? Dressed? Oh, you mean the hermit? Oh, I tossed him a few gill and we need an extra pair of hands. He doesn't talk about himself, and I sure as hell don't ask. When a man's got a face with scars like that, you best leave it well enough alone, I say. If you mind to find him, though, then head southwest to the severed string. Okay. Deliver the wine to Dressed. Mount Roulette. We get Griffin. I'll unfreeze it in a second. I gotta go through a dangerous, not dangerous, but area full of wild jungle curls that will aggro me. There's frogs in the water. Look at that. Hello. Yeah, waterfall there. No, Giganto, don't fight Miro. Alright, we have arrived. Give me a moment here. Just gonna reset my screen share. Alright. And it has been reset. Here's Dressed. You ready?
Yep. What do you want?
Lamani Rosso. Shamani Lamani's first attempt at winemaking. At least the name sounds legitimate.
Wine? I didn't ask for this. Who sent you?
That weight. Dressed is suffering from extreme duress. I get an eye patch, that's better than what I'm wearing. Okay.
Can't sleep. They won't let me sleep. The midges. The buzzing. It keeps me awake. I never wanted to hurt anyone. I won't fight. I don't want to fight. Please, make the buzzing stop. Make the midges go away.
Okay. Midges away. So we gotta go beat up 5 swarms of dung midges. Dung midge swarm. I don't know how I'm fighting with a midge swarm. That just baffles the mind, but... There it is. We are fighting with a swarm of bugs. Dung midges at that. Alright. Maybe kind of hard, too. Okay, there we are. Fight. Oh. Alright. One more. I know. Two more. Two more. I can't count, apparently. There's a Gooboo, though. Hello, Gooboo. Man, these bugs are like, most of these are really far away. I don't know how they're keeping the guy awake. I got a milled dude, Gooboo. Alright, we're gonna move away. No, he wants to fight. Alright, this isn't good.
Not the Gooboo.
Sorry, Gooboo. I don't really want to fight, but you're not leaving me much choice here. I have one more midge swarm to kill. There we go. Okay. Off we go. Before we talk to Drest again, I will reset my recording for the final bit of today's stream. Hey look, they respawned. Our efforts were for naught. Alright. So, hopping off the Chocobo, resetting the recording.